அஸ்மத் குருபியோ நமகா, அஸ்மத் சர்வகுருபியோ நமகா, அஸ்மத் பரமகுருபியோ நமகா, ஸ்ரீமதே ஸ்ரீ லக்ஷ்மி நரசிம்ம பரபிரமணே நமகா, ஸ்ரீமதே சிவன் ஷடகோபஸ்ரீ வேதாந்த தேசிகேந்திர மகாதேசிகாய நமகா, ஸ்ரீமதே ஸ்ரீ லக்ஷ்மி நரசிம்ம திவ்ய பாதுகா சேவக சிவன் ஷடகோப ஸ்ரீ நாராயணேந்திர மகாதேசிகாய நமகா, ஸ்ரீமதே சிவன் ஷடகோப ஸ்ரீ ரங்கநாதேந்திர மகாதேசிகாய நமகா, ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கடநாதாரிய கவிதார்க்கிகேசரி வேதாந்தாச்சாரிய வரியோ மே சந்நிதத்தாம் சதா ஹிருதி ஞானானந்தமயம் தேவம் நிர்மலஸ்படிகாகிருதிம் ஆதாரம் சர்வ வித்யானாம் ஹயக்ரீவமுபாஸ்மகே. வந்தே பிருந்தாவனச்சரம் வல்லவீஜனவல்லபம் ஜயந்தி சம்பவம் தாம வைஜயந்தி விபூஷணம் ஜன்மாத்யஸ்ய யதோன்வயாதித்தரத சார்த்தேஷ விஜ்ஞஸ்வராட் தேனே பிரம்மஹிருதாய ஆதிகவயே முஹ்யந்தி யத் சூரயஃ தேஜோ வாரிமிருதாம் யதா விநிமயோ யத்ர த்ஸர்கோ மிருஷா தாம்னா ஸ்வேன சதா நிரஸ்த குஹகம் சத்யம் பரம் தீமஹி நிகமகல்பதரோர்களிதம் பலம் சுகமுகாதமிருதத்ரவசம்யுதம் பிபத பாகவதம் ரசமாலயம் முகுரஹோ ரசிகா புவி பாவுகாஹ கிருஷ்ணாய வாசுதேவாய தேவகீ நந்தனாய ச நந்தகோபகுமாராய கோவிந்தாய நமோ நமஹ. நம பங்கஜநாபாய நம பங்கஜமாலினே நம பங்கஜநேத்ராய நமஸ்தே பங்கஜாங்கிரயே. வேதத்தை வேதத்தின் சுவைப்பயனை விழுமிய முனிவர்கள் விழுங்கும் கோதலின் கனியை நந்தனார்களிற்றை குவலையத்தோர் தொழுதேத்தும் ஆதியை அமுதை என்னை ஆளுடை அப்பனை ஒப்பவரெல்லா மாதர்கள் வாழும் மாடமாமையிலை திருவல்லிக்கே நிகண்டேனே. வசுதேவ சுதம் தேவம் கம்சச்சாணூரமர்தனம் தேவகீ பரமானந்தம் கிருஷ்ணம் வந்தே ஜகத்குரும். தும் து சர்வம் பரித்யஜ்ய ஸ்நேகம் ஸ்வஜன பந்துஷு மயா வேஷ்ய மனசம்யக் சமத்ருக் விசரஸ்வகாம் யதிதம் மனசா வாசா சக்ஷுர்வ்யாம் ஶ்ரவணாதிபிஹி நஸ்வரம் க்ருஹ்யமாணஞ்ச வித்தி மாயா மனோமயம். பும்சோ யுக்தஸ்ய நானார்த்தோ ப்ரமஸக் குணதோஷபாக் கர்மா கர்ம விகர்மேதி குணதோஷதியோபிதா தஸ்மாத் யுக்தேந்திரிய க்ராமோ யுக்த சித்த இதம் ஜகது ஆத்மநீஷஸ்வ விததம் ஆத்மானம் மையதீஸ்வரே ஞான விஜான சம்யுக்த ஆத்மபூத ஷரீரிணாம் ஆத்மானுபவ துஷ்டாத்மா நாந்தராயைர்பிகன்யசே தோஷபுத்தியோபயாதீதோ நிஷதான்ன நிவர்த்ததே குணபுத்தியாச்ச விஹிதம் ந கரோதி யதர்பகஹ சர்வபூத சுகிருத் சாந்தோ ஞான விஜ்ஞான நிச்சயஹ பஷ்யன்மத் ஆத்மகம் விஸ்வம் ந விபத்யேத வை புனஹ. வி ஆர் என்ஜாயிங் தி உத்தவ கீதா. டுடே இஸ் தி 96th லெக்சர் அண்ட் வி ஆர் ஸ்டில் இன் தி 11th ஸ்கந்தம், தட் இஸ் தி உத்தவ கீதா எவ்ரி திங் இன் பாகவதம். 12 ஸ்கந்தம்ஸ் ஆர் தேர். 10th ஸ்கந்தம் இஸ் அபவுட் தி கிருஷ்ணாஸ் லீலா, கிருஷ்ணா கெட்ஸ் மேரிட், கிருஷ்ணா ஹெல்ப்ஸ் தி பாண்டவ், எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் ஓவர் தேர். 11th ஸ்கந்தம் மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தி டைம் பீப்புள் ஆல்வேஸ் ஸ்கிப் வென் தே கிவ் தி பாகவம் சப்தாகம். They do up to the Rukmani Kalyanam and stop it. This is the one, the last days of Krishna. This probably would be just a week before Krishna went back to the moksham. At that time, his closest friend, closest counsel, biggest bhakta, Uddhava, is coming and both of them are having a some kind of a samvadam, basically the dialogue between them. So Uddhava says, Krishna says, I want to go back. Uddhava says, I cannot stay without you, Krishna. I am like a fish without water. Please take me wherever you go. Then Krishna says, no, my path is different. I got a red carpet. And what you have to go through your karma. You cannot come on the same thing. However close you are to the Bhagavan, you still have to go through your karmas. That is what he was telling him. So at that time, the slokas what we read, all the seven slokas, Krishna was telling him. And Uddhava said, it's way above my head, what you told. Krishna, I understand what it is, but I don't know how to implement them. Just like he said, if you want to live very happily, become a lawyer. I understand that, but tell me how I become a lawyer. So that is what he was asking. So the next about 900 slokas is basically Krishna is explaining by various ways to Uddhava. So the first round, Uddhava did not understand. Then said, okay, let me explain to you based on story. This is what the story about Yadu Maharaja in our ancestor. And he met Avadhuta Sannyasi, who is a Brahmana. He was jumping around everything with just a loin cloth. He didn't have anything, no relations, no wealth, no house, no food, but he was happy. Yadu Maharaja has got everything in his palace, but he was not. So he was asking him, what is the secret? So he was telling about the 24 different kinds of gurus and everything. Krishna told, you learn everything from nature. Lot of things you learn from people. So these are the things you learn. So Uddhava, looking at all of them, then he said, I understand. But when you look at the sun or when you look at the tree or the sea, everybody looks at the same. What I am going to learn particularly from that sea from anybody else? So how do you modify, tailor this kind of your guru rather than they keep on sending you the whole notes to everybody? I want to have one-to-one coaching, Krishna. Tell me what I have to do so that I understand all of them. So Krishna says, most of the time there is no one-to-one coaching is needed. You are your own teacher. Nobody else is your teacher. But I'm giving you a lot of these things, tools, you will figure it out. So he goes to the next level. After the first round of seven slogans, now he's going to the second level. The practical means of achieving. So he says, Avadhuta said, the happiness is give up everything. Happiness is going to be renunciation. To become the qualities of a sannyasi, he says. Then he is asking Uddhava, how can I become this one? What is the practical means how to achieve this one? Krishna said, as like anything else, very simple. Follow the Shastra, have the Bhakti, have the Anushtanam, have the Acharam. Following what Acharya said, don't hurt anybody. These are the things. Again, this looks like very, very generic one. So he is asking, what should I do? What should I follow all of them? Then Krishna told about four slogans. Again, here also, Krishna put everything in a very high level. It is hard to understand for most of them. We looked at all the four slogans. The first one says, Maya udideshu avahidaha, sudharmeshu mat ashrayaha, varnashrama kula acharam, agama atma samacharet. Maya udideshu avahidaha. Hey, Uddhava, I have told a lot of things. Follow them very carefully. In that one, what I said, sudharmam, what is the dharma for each one of them? This is only people, mat ashreha. If you come to me, if you surrender to me, these are the things you have to follow. So let's assume if you are going to become a doctor, you have to follow certain discipline. Like you have to pass the exam, you have to do certain kinds of thing. Similarly, if you are surrendering to me, these are the things you have to do. All others, I don't care because they are going to go back again into the samsara. But you want to get out of that one, you want to enjoy the Bhagavan, permanent, nitya, ananda, ananda, kainkaryam. So this is what I am telling you. Swadharmeshu, you have to follow swadharmam. Varnashrama, kula acharam, whatever your kulam, whatever is following, and acharam, that is also very important. Akama atma samachare, whenever you do, akama, don't get entangled into that one. You have to have a vairagyam on that. So you do all these things without any pradipalan, without having any attachment. So vairagyam, that is the one he was stressing on that. So in the second sloka, Krishna was saying, anvikshada vishuddha atma dehinam vishaya atmanam गुणेषु तत्त्वज्ञानेन सर्व आरंभ विपर्ययम् अन्विक्षेद विशुद्धात्मा द प्यूर क्लीन माइंडेड पीपल व्हाट दे डू दे लुक एट एवरीथिंग एंड लर्न हाउ डू दे लर्न तत्त्वज्ञानेन कृष्णा टोल्ड दिस इज द बॉटम You have to understand the Tattvam. Tattvam means reality. In our Visishtadvaita Tattvam is based on three. Tattvatrayam, Chit, Achit, Ishwaran. Yes, we said Achit, Chit, Ishwaran. Yes, you got that one. And then Achit is inanimate things, non-sentient. Chitti means all the Atmas, whether the Atma inside you or the bird or the animals or any of them. And Ishwaran is Bhagavan is the only one. So based on these three, everything, we are all becoming a Shariram for Bhagavan. Bhagavan supports, Bhagavan controls, Bhagavan owns all these things. This is what the Tattvatrayam Krishna himself says over here. Mumukshuvagiya chetanakku moksham undagum bodhu Tattvatraya jnanam undaga venum. Another Acharya called Pillaloka Acharya, he wrote in Tamil, Mumukshu, the one who is interested in moksha. Desire as moksham. If you want to know, go to moksham, you have to start with Tattvatrayam. What is Chit, Achit, Ishwara? Because that is Visishta Advaitam. If you go to the Advaitam, they say, there's nothing. There's only one. Brahman is the only one. All the things what we see is a Maya. So if you realize yourself, so when you do all of them, Jiva Mukti, when you got that one, there is moksham is not a place. That is what they say, that one. In ours, it is not. It's entirely two different Atma types. Bhagavan is only one Atma type, Ishwaran. We are all another one called Jivatma types. Our job is to serve him. That is how it's coded inside. So inside that one, it's coded within Atma, that which cannot change. So whether you go to any place or whether you go to any number of yugas, that cannot be changed. So Chit, Achit, Ishwaran. That is what he says. If you understand this one, then you are asking, Swarupa, Sthiti, Pravritti. That is what in a Visishtadvaitam say. What is the Swarupam? What is the Swarupam of this Atma if you ask that one to serve the Bhagavan? Sthiti, how it stays? Because Bhagavan gives a life with this body and everything, you do that one. Pravritti, whatever the actions you do, based on the karma and based on what Bhagavan allows. So this is a Swarupa, Sthiti, Pravritti, all these kinds of things, you analyze all of them. Because Bhagavan gives you the body for this Atma to stay and gives the manasa, he gives the indriyams and everything. What we do? Dehinam vishayatmanam guneshu. You go into the angle of the indriyams. So why? Because you have three gunas, sattva, rajasa, tamasa, and they control. That is why you're going into that. So once you start going, the Atma belongs to the Bhagavan. It wants to serve him. But when you put it inside over here, the body, and the body is looking for all the indriya sugam, ulaga vishayanubhavam, when it wants to do that one, you forget. So you can serve only one. Either you can serve for your body or you can serve for the Bhagavan. So that is what he says, dehinam vishayatmanam. Once you do that one, what happens is indriya sugam, then you forget about that. So if you want to come to me, forget about the indriya sugam. Because those are alpa, astira, palat. Don't listen to your sensual pleasures. Don't bury yourself into the worldly activities and everything. That is what he was saying over there. So in this one, basically he says, the process of becoming desireless. That is what he is saying. How do you develop the vairagyam? Because you understand the tattvam. Once you understand the tattvam, then you know what it is. Still, Uddhava does not understand. See, all this tattvam, what he is trying to say, so many things we go through. All the objects we see, the form, the taste, the flavor, the touch, the sound, everything is temporary. Nothing stays forever. The family, relation, society, nation, all your animals, pets, everything, none of them is permanent. Everything is. Even your own body is a temporary one. Thus, what happens is, if you go through all of them, final result what you are getting for all these pleasures, sadness. That is what it will happen. Vibharyaya, he says that. He said, sarva aramba vibharyaya. If you keep on indulging that one, even though it looks good, initially, there is nothing in this world is completely wrong. There's nothing in the world completely right. So it is a mixture of them. So what you have to do is when you have a jalebi, if you take one jalebi, it tastes good. It's nice for your stomach. It's for good for your tongue. So for that one, you take a 2 dozen of them, then you fall sick for 2 weeks. So there is always a balance in that one. So Krishna tries to say here, you have to indulge in worldly activities so that you can survive. That is the level. Not anything more on that one, because indulgence becomes overindulgence. Remember the first day we started with 3 lanes. Rightmost lane, center lane, and the leftmost lane. The center lane is called Bhoga lane. So Bhoga lane is always fat. So if somebody wants to, okay, why don't you taste this one, tell me how it is. They give a jalebi, you take a piece and taste. If you take 10 jalebis, that is not tasting. That is bhogam. That is what we do. So what they are asking, do minimal things for the body, minimal things for your wife, minimal things for your kids, minimal things what you want to indulge. If you do that one, it is no problem. What happens is, there's nothing wrong if you go more. One day, something is not going to work for you, you will become sad at the end. So that is what it says. If you know that one, why don't you stop yourself? So the renunciation is not coming from withdrawing from everything. Renunciation coming, going close to each one of them with a limited level without any expectation back. So sannyasramam is not running away from society. Sannyasramam is going towards the society in terms of helping them, in terms of making everybody good. Like acharyas, look at our acharyas. What they do every day, sannyasi, I'm not going to talk, they are not going away. They are talking thousands of people. But what you eat, what you dress, and what you do, and what he does, what he eats, look at that. It's a difference. So he never expects anything back. His lifestyle is different, but he is here to help you. That is the kind of the attitude. You don't have to have a saffron robe, but that is what the attitude you have to get. So in the second sloka, he says, try to be desireless. In the third one, Krishna says, Suptasya Vishaya Loga Dhyayayado Va Manoradaha Nanatmagatvad Vibalaha Tada Vedatma Dhirgunaihi Suptasya Vishaya Loga. One goes through the dream. So many dreams we are getting, all of them. Not only that, Dhyayayado Va Manoradaha is doing dhyanam on his manoradam. So many daydreams. Not only in the night he is getting all of them, daydreams also he is getting all of them. Nanatmagatvad vibalaha. All this multitude of things you go through, all of them is a waste. Useless thing. You sit here and think, oh, what happens if I win the lottery? If I get this one, what would happen? So if I do this one, what would happen? You think all of them, 2 seconds later, everything is a useless. You wasted your time. Manoradaha, all of them. Tada bedatma dhirgunehi. The dirka darishi, when he looks at that one, you look at the way how my life is going to be, rest of the period is based on my karma. Whatever I have done, my punyam and pavam, Bhagavan is going to give that. When I'm going to die is not in my hand. When I have to be born is not in my hand. To whom I should be born is not in my hand. Which place I have to die is not in your hand. None of them is in your hand. So the birth is not in your hand, death is not in your hand, but in between you think that you have some control of everything. None of them is in your control. So bedatma dirgunait, so dirga gunam, whatever he thinks, I try my best. Whatever you say, Krishna says, karmanye badiharaste ma palesha kathasana. All you have to do is do your duty. You go to the airport right on time. Whether the plane leaves from the Paris, come back here, or you have to go through a couple of countries and come back, it's not in your hand. Because Bhagavan does that one. We saw that one in that saying, Maya Manam, Maya Mayam, Mano Mayam. The second sloka, we saw that one. Bhagavan does all of them. It is a combination of you and the Bhagavan put together. So here he says in the third sloka, all the pleasures are temporary. If you understand that one, the final result is the same. If the final result is the same, then what you have to do? Let's assume, take very common example. Sunday is the Ekadesi coming. So next Ekadesi is Vaikuntha Ekadesi. So this is in between Kaisika Ekadesi and Vaikuntha Ekadesi we are having next week. On Ekadesi day, one guy is eating 7-meal course. And the other guy is not eating anything. So let's say 2 hours later, 4 hours later, both of them sleep, next morning wake up. Is there any difference between them? Nothing. He is also hungry, that guy is also hungry. So what do we say? You've gone through all this cooking and eating and all of them. What is the use of that? There's nothing. So you can easily do. So you cannot stretch that one out and say, if you can do Ekadesi for one day, what can you do for 1 month? No, our bodies are not made like that. Our bodies are fragile. So we are not like rishis and everything. So whatever you can do, even putting the body into the torture is wrong in our Shastra. There are people who take the chain and beat their body and everything. Those are the things you cannot do. Because the Atma, to stay in this body, it has given a place. So you have to be, this is like a temple and the Atma is like a Bhagavan staying inside. So you have to take care of that up to a certain extent so that you can live normal life. So you cannot beat up or you cannot have too much of luxuries also. So here it says, after some time, whether you do the Ekadesi or not Ekadesi, it comes to the same. So the guy thinks tomorrow morning it's going to be, let me bite my teeth, let me sit over here and tomorrow morning it will be okay. So the same result is going to come. Alpa Asthira Palat. So don't go for that one. You go for the ultimate Purusharthaam. That is what it's saying. How do I do that one? Shuruba, Ruba, Guna, Leelas and everything. Ekadesi, if you are staying next to the, close to the restaurant, next to the kitchen, next to the, all the things, then it's a problem. So instead of then move away. That is called, whenever they call Vradam, what it means is you go and try to stay closer to the Bhagavan, not closer to the kitchen, because the temptation is there for everybody. So the way to get out of that, think about Bhagavan kind of a thing. Third sloka I was telling. First sloka he said, follow Acharya, whatever they say, Dharma Shastram and your Swadharmam and everything. Second sloka he says, how you became a desireless and everything. Third sloka says, I'm telling you why you have to be desireless, because all the desires you go through is a temporary one, it's a waste. Then fourth one he says, Nivrittam karma sevada pravrittam mat parastyajet jigyasayam sampravrutto natriyet karma chodana matparaha. Krishna loves that. Matparaha. The one who has done surrender to me, the one who thinks I am going to give the refuge for him. Those to him. Jigyasayam, jigyasayam. Jigyasa means nyadumicha jigyasa. The one who is interested to expand his knowledge. Not the knowledge of the worldly things, the knowledge about Bhagavan. That is the highest prameyam. So jigyasayam sampravrutto. So if you want to do that one, explore on the tattvas, he says. Nivritta sevada. Here he is saying there are two dharmas are there. One is called pravritti. The other one is called Nivritti. Nivritti means putting a full stop for everything, period. Pravritti means getting more and more into that one. Let's take a simple example. Pravritti, you go there, this is a beautiful car, I want to buy. So you bought the car. So what happens after that? You have to make a check. You have to get a plate. And you have to pay the tax. You have to fill the gas. You have to go over clean. Each one gets more and more and more and more into that. That is called pravritti. Even though you think that is good, nothing comes free. Let's assume the guy thinks, I don't need it. This is too difficult to maintain a car in Manhattan. I'm going to go and sell it. So he sold that one. From tomorrow, do you have to worry what is the gas price? Do you have to worry about what is taking into the tune-up for the car? Or whether the tires change or anything? None of them you have to worry about it. So the less, the lighter you are, the higher you fly. That is what it says over here. So nivritti, nivritti dharma, pravritti dharma. So pravritti dharma means it, even the social service is also pravritti dharma. Because when you go and do that one, not only it keeps on adding more, but we are not saying we should remove completely. Pravritti dharma, anything that where you are expecting a return. See, as long as akama there, that is what Krishna says, no desire on that. You can go and do. Today they called you to do, go and sweep the whole floor there. I go and do it. That's it. I'm not getting anything back. Tomorrow if they call, I go and do. So there is no pravritti, but you are doing some social service. So there are in the nivritti and pravritti dharma, there are four purusharthams are there. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha, all the four. In this pravritti and nivritti you take, dharma is common for all of them. Because any action you do, it has to follow some rules. Whether you go in the car for pleasure, whether you go for a business, you still have to obey the rules of the road. Same thing here. Pravritti and nivritti, all of them, it has to follow the dharma. The artha and kama is only for pravritti. Moksha is called nivritti. Moksham is called nivritti dharmam. So understand the tattvam that leads you into nivritti, nivritti margam. So what leads you into the nivritti margam? What tattvams will do? So we saw that one anytime when you do the action, it called sattvika tyagam. Sattvika tyagam is pravrittam karma tyajet. Give up on the pravritti dharmas, he said, indulgence on worldly things. Na atriyet karma chodanam. You don't have to, na atriyet, don't support karma chodanam, rules of the karma. What it means is not general karma, kamya karma. Don't do any kamya karma. So what here it says, nivritti dharma is based on dora, we told, sattvika tyagam, doer, objective, reaper and access. Kartritva tyagam, mamada tyagam, pala tyagam, pala ubhayatva tyagam. All the four you had to give up. Anytime when you do, you think that you have done all of them. Okay. So, kartritva tyagam, let's give a simple example. I always give that one. You get a headache. You want to go to the pharmacy and get the Tylenol. So, kartritva tyagam, I am the one going. Kartritvam, I am the one going. So, you are the doer. Second one, I go to the pharmacy to get Tylenol for me, not to get anything for you. The objective is only for me. Reaper, when you go there and you bought the Tylenol, the guy next to you, he says, I also have headaches, sir, can you give me? He says, no, the pollen is only for me. So, the reaper. And then when you come back home, so your headache is cleared. So your wife says, see how the headache is cleared. Then you say, how it is cleared? I am the one went there. I am the one got it. And I am the one eat that one. That is why it is cleared. I am the ubhayam for this palan. So kartritva tyagam, mamada tyagam, pala tyagam, pala ubhayatya tyagam. You take it, doer, objective, reaper and access. None of them is you. Once you get that in your head, it's all these things you are like. Like Bhagavan gives you a little freedom. We are like the dummies. All this a puppet show kind of a thing. Bhagavan is moving. If you understand that, then life is easier. So that is what it says. In the nivritti dharma, start giving up. Don't start pointing inside, pointing it out. So I have to do for you. Not pointing it out means not blaming it on others. Pointing it out means your efforts should be on other people. Not taking all the credits towards you. So finally, in the four slogans, if you really look at that one, Krishna beautifully says what Bhagavat Ramanujar says later in Sri Bhashyam. Before that, what it says in Brahma Sutram. In the Brahma Sutram, what it says in the Vyasa Bhagavan, there are sadhana sadushtayam. Sadhana sadushtayam means there are four things you need if you want to really go to the moksha. The first one is Nitya, Anitya, Vastu, Vivekam. First you have to understand what is permanent, what is not permanent. That is very important. Second one, Iva Mutra Palaboha Viharaha. Iva, this is here. Amutra, next life and everything. Palabogam, all the palan what you are getting. Viharaha, I don't want all of them. Virupu, disgust. Third one, Samadamadi Sadhana Sambattakal. Samam and Dhamam, all the external indriyam and internal indriyam, manas, all of them have to be calm. Fourth one is Mumukshutvam. You had to have an ichchai, you had to have a desire to go to moksham. All these four are prerequisite. Not only prerequisite, again and again and again you indulge and come out of that is how you go. not as a standalone prerequisite. You pass all those things, then only you go to moksha. It is not. In the life, you go through that one. I understand how much I have done for my wife, how much I have done for my kids, how much I have done all these things. None of them is useless. So once when you go through all of them, then you realize all of them are temporary. Then only you go to the Bhagavan. That is what it says. These four. And if you look at these four slokas, what Krishna said matches with all the four. 1, 2, 3, 4. The first one Krishna was saying basically, follow the acharam, follow the anushtanam, follow the kula dharma, varnashrama dharma. What all they say? All of them say, don't go to the worldly things, go to the Bhagavan. Nitya, anitya, vastu, vivegam. That is what it gives. Second one, it says, don't give yourself to the sensual pleasures. Don't go into the worldly things. Ivamutra palaboha viharaha. So why? Because all of them are temporary and you're going to regret. Third one, he says all the pleasures are temporary, Krishna said. Eventually it's going to be samadhamadi sadhana sambandhukal. So when you know they are all temporary, your mind, see if you really look for something, I'm really hungry in Yagadesi. You just wait for 3 hours, the hunger goes away. So you know that one, you know how to control. So if you control like that one, then makes life easier. The third one, everything is temporary if you know, then samadhamadi sadhana sampattukal. It automatically comes to you. And the fourth sloka says, you have to be interested in nivritti dharma, not pravritti dharma. That is mumukshutva. So Krishna told exactly what the Brahma Sutram says, but in a different way. That's all it is. So if you go through, whether Sri Bhashyam, whether you go through Ragasyatra Saram, whether you go to Tirupavai, whether you go through Gajendra Moksham, any of our class, all of them hinges on these four. And all the slogans, whatever they say, they cannot say 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. Any which way they try to explain to you, taking a 2 plus 2 in green color and show you, or a red color and show you, all of them is the same thing. A rose is a rose by any other name. So this is the bottom line we have to understand. So coming back here, now we go into the fifth one. So when he says sadhana sadushtayam, hey, understand nitya anitya vastu. Vivegam. So second one, Imamuttara Palaboga Viharaka. Here, or even they give you Surgam, or even they give you Devendran possession, or Brahma possession, I don't want it. Third one, I want to be calm and cool and think about it. Only when you are calm, your mind will be rational. Okay. And the last one is basically Mumukshutvam. So these four, when they are told to Uddhava, Uddhava says, I don't understand still. You say all these things. Samadhamadi sadhana sambandhukal. You have to control your indriyam, you have to control your heart, and then you say, being desireless. Krishna, how do I do that? If they put a ton of jalebis in front of me, how can I have that one? Same thing with the Nayagana in Indra, Nandagopan, Parshuram also says, indriya nigraham. This is what he is asking. How do I control my indriyams? So next, Krishna goes in a little different path, and we'll show. This is for the Bhakti Yoga. Bhakti and Prabhati are two different paths. Even though both of them will give the same result. One of them depends on your jnanam and shakti and anushtanam and patience. Prabhati does not depend any of them. It shows you are disqualified in all of them. You are unqualified in all of them. That is why we do. Both of them, when you do it, all of them, tulya vikalpam, two different paths, but finally they give the same results for you. So here, Krishna is going to tell about the Ashtanga Yogam over here. Yaman abhikshanam sevada niyaman matparaha kvajite mat abhigyam gurum shantam ubhasida mat atmaham matparaha. Again uses the same word. 3 or 4 times he uses this word in all this sloga. I'm telling not to everybody. There are people, they love this world. They say, don't rock the boat. I don't want any Perumal. I don't want any spiritual thing, religious things and coming and interfering. I'm enjoying everything in Hawaii. So don't bother me. So for them, I'm not telling. People want to come to me because we go through the cycle of this sadhana sadushtayam, mumukshutvam, you understand. Then goes back into the nitya nitya vastu vivegam. You don't get it. So this is constantly going back and forth, these four things. So Matparaha, the one who has surrendered to me, Krishna repeats this word and says, the one surrendered to me or ready to surrender. Yes, I heard a lot of them. Krishna, I want to come and do prabhati. I want to get the moksha. I am ready for that. I have some knowledge on this one. I am very willingly. I am having a pleasure to go and do this one. I am desirous of that. I am craving for that. When you say like that one, Yaman abhikshanam sevada. Yaman. Yaman means yam. Yam means going away. Yam. Yamaha. Yamaha comes only from that. Going away. So yama. Yamam, niyamam, asanam. That is the kind of ashtanga yoga is basically coming. So let me explain this sloka and then come into that. Yamam. Qualities like yamam, niyamam, pranayamam, etc. Abhikshanam always. Sevada should be observed. Things like yamam, niyamam, all those things, always you should observe them. Niyaman kvachite. There are certain things called niyamam. See, yamam means what you should not do. Niyamam means what you should do. Okay? The niyamam, whatever you should do, try to do it kvachite. Whenever it's possible, try to do. So there are sometimes you cannot, because the restriction may be there. Kala, desha, so many different kinds of things that may stop you. Shantam, mat abhigyam, mat atmagam gurum. So Uddhava says, I don't understand. Then Krishna says, I told all these things. Uddhava, you need an acharya. So that is what he says. All these things I told you, there is somebody else will tell you. Why he says somebody else will tell you over here? You need an acharya to do the sharanagati. You need an acharya to teach you the bhakti yogam. Either you go to the bhakti yogam or prabhati, without acharya you cannot do. You cannot self-learn all these kinds of things. So here it says, Uddhava, for anybody, not necessarily Uddhava, anybody listens over here, you need an acharya. So now I give you the qualification of an acharya right now, and then I'll give the qualification of the sishya next one. Just like in Ragasetra Saram at the end, Sishyakritya Adhigaram, Acharya Kritya Adhigaram. What Acharyan should do, what Sishyan do, Swami Desikan says. He says, Santam. That is the first thing. For an Acharya, you always have to be calm and cool. If you're getting angry, if you're getting sad, if you're laughing too highly and everything, you are not an Acharya. Acharya means even there's a huge atom bomb in front of him, he just stands there and look at very politely. That is the thing you need. First quality for Acharya is Shantam. Krishna says that one. They used to make a fun. They put a wedding invitation and then try to send it to all the people. So when you send it to all the big people, then you have to write everything. Vedamarka Pradishtapana Acharya, Vaya Vedanta Acharya, all those things you write. So when you send it to him, he came. Look, you have missed this one. You didn't have the Shanta in that one. Last time when you sent it for your daughter's wedding, you put all of them. Now you're missing all of them. See, look how you are coming. That's why I didn't put it. Shantam. You need Shantam for that. So the first quality for Acharya is a Shantam. Krishna says that one. Mat abhigyam. Mat abhigyam means you has to understand me. If you don't understand Bhagavan, he cannot be an Acharya. He can be a computer guru or automobile mechanic guru. But to become an acharya, Shantam is first one. Second one, Mat Abhigyam. Mat Abhigyam means here says, he has to understand. If you are Shantam and if you understand him, third qualification he gives, Mat Atmagam. He will be just like me. Krishna says, the acharya will be just like me. So Shantam, the one you understand is just like me. That is why when we go to the Acharya, we think he is the walking Bhagavan. See, the Bhagavan in Achyamurti and temple does not walk. He stays there. But the Acharyan is equivalent of that because Krishna says three qualities over here. Shantam, Mat Abhigyam, Mat Atmagam, Gurum. Go and find that Guru. He will give you the moksha. Without Guru, there is no moksha. Ubasidaha. That Guru, you start worshipping him. Ubasidaha. Upasi is not towards Perumal. He says, towards that Guru you start. How Krishna is saying over here, all the four sadhana sadhushtya I give you, but to go to moksham, either root of bhakti or a prabhati, you cannot do by yourself. You have need a guru. And let me give you some clue. When you are going for a guru, look who is calm and cool in everything. That is why they say, now who is an acharyan? The guy comes so mad and he is cutting his left hand. When he is cutting his left hand, it's bleeding. The right hand, he takes acharya and putting Dirgha Vishman Bhava for him. That is the acharya. So you need that kind of a quality to get that one. They say acharya means, acharya is like a, many places they give the quotes, it's like a baby. Baby doesn't, not like a, whenever you want to eat, no, not like from that angle. Baby means, today you go to, there's about a 1 year, 2 year old baby, you get really mad. Even you beat that baby, let's assume. Tomorrow you... So Krishna body says over here, even though you want to come to me and surrender and get the Parama Purushartha Moksham, I'm like a wholesale guy. You have to go to the retail person. The retail person is basically the acharyas. They will show you all of them. The four things I said in the sadhana sadushtyam, you cannot master all of them. There are people who mastered them. Go to them. They will show the path. And that's, you don't have to worry about it, because they are not going to take anything from you. They are all desireless. All they are here to help you. So you never been afraid to go to the acharya. Oh, I'm so afraid. I don't want to tell everything. Maybe you can use this one against me. Or maybe you can take money from me. Maybe you can take all this thing. No, he will not. That is why he's an acharya. He's not going to take. He's there to give you all of them. So Krishna says, you go to him. Shantam, mat abhigyam, mat atmaham. These three, understand. Shantam, always calm and cool. Doesn't matter what kind of errors, what kind of sins, you go to him and says, I did this one. What? You did all of them? He did not ask that one. Doesn't matter. Yesterday, how you live until yesterday is not a big deal. From today onwards, you're going to be a good person. So, mat abhigyam, who understand me, mat atmam, he just like me. That's what he says. So now we are going into the two paths we said, bhakti yogam and prabhati yogam. The bhakti yogam basically coming from ashtanga yogam, ashta anga, eight accessories are there. It has been done by the Patanjali Yoga Sutras. So we're going to go and look at a little about that one. We don't want to do too much into that, mainly because, see, we are taking one expressway and we are looking at the Google Maps, the other expressway is blocked, it's all traffic jam and everything. So we are looking at that one and saying, oh boy, we took this path, at least we can go faster. It is not like that. You don't want to dwell on that one because you are not in that road. Why you want to know about all of them? All we want to know for a comparative purpose where you are. That's all it is. So for a comparative purpose, what the Bhakti Yogam people do, what we do, that's all we do. If you start indulging too much into that one, rather than you may miss your path over here. So Ashtanga Yogam, we are going to understand a little bit over here. In the Patanjali Sutra, first is comes with Yamam. Yam means going away and withdrawal, that is called Yam. Here, Yam comes from five different things. This is the don't. The next one is Niyamam, which is the do. So don't and do, let's look at that one. Don't, he says, there are five things are there. Again, all these things are told in so many different places in a different fashion. This is Patanjali's classification. He says, first one is Ahimsa. Ahimsa means abstinence from hurting or killing anything. This is not only abstinence, it's Mano, Vak, Kaye. Ahimsa in all of them. So if you look at that one, Ahimsa, you cannot say, I did Ahimsa. What do you mean by you did Ahimsa? You don't do Himsa. Okay? That is why it's a don't. Nobody cannot practice Ahimsa. If you don't do certain things, it automatically becomes Ahimsa. Second one is Satyam. Satyam is, oh, I'm Satyavan. How can it be Satyavan? You didn't tell a lie. That is why you are a Satyavan. So don't. So next one is Asteyam. Not stealing. Okay? So I am doing asteyam. You cannot say unless I am not stealing. Not, that has to be. That's why it is all in the don't classification. Ahimsa, satyam, asteyam, brahmacharyam. Brahmacharya means purity. Purity is not necessarily brahmacharya. We are talking for everybody, the way how you behave in the mind, in the walk and the actions and everything, it has to be a very clean person. So that is what brahmacharyam. Next one, aparigraha. Don't accumulate too much. Don't. So again, aparigraha means that's also don't. So all the five things in the MM, it says ahimsa, satyam, asteyam, brahmacharyam, aparigraha. And all of them are connected with one to the other, if you look at that one. See, if you are aparigraha, if you don't follow that one, you start collecting and then you are used to that one. Somewhere or other you want to get that. And today you are having a great job and money you are doing. Tomorrow if you don't have it and you got used to that one, and you will find some other way to get that. So that is where it goes into the all other kinds of bad habits. And same thing, to do that bad habits, you go away not telling the truth. Satyam will be gone. Or sometimes you have to beat up somebody and get what you need. That goes into the himsa. So all these things one way or other related. So the last one is called aparigraha. That is the one very key. So if you have that one, don't accumulate more than what you need. So Swami Desikan says, here is a whole pond. And he says, all I can drink a cup of water. But there is a pond is there, it doesn't make any difference for me. That is what this Avadhuta was saying. See, we all accumulate money. The accumulate money is for what? Accumulating money is because you are scared. That is the only thing. None of the materials will make you happy. I tell you, the things that makes you happy or sad is your own indriyams. Okay? If the jalebi is there, jalebi will not make you happy unless your tongue tastes that one. Okay? If the same jalebi, after you put the 3 pounds in your mouth, the tongue becomes dead. So eat the jalebi. The jalebi is karam. Jalebi is spicy. That's what you would say. So it's jalebi is not doing anything. Only you doing all of them. None of the materials will give you the happiness. Only you find the happiness on that. So he separates these two. So you separate that one. Inanimate things are not going to do. Now next one you go. The inanimate things to the people. None of the people can make you happy. None of the people can make you sad. It is with you. It tries to say that way. So that is what you have to understand. Yamam. Yamam means you withdraw. Withdraw means what? You go to the people, but withdraw your feelings. Withdraw your expectations. That is the first thing you have to do. Patanjali put all these things in this sequential order. Not necessarily that order Bhakti Yogam will go in. Bhakti Yogam depends on which one of the 31 Brahma Vidyas you go, different things you will start with, not all this order. But he has put in a sequential order like that, Yamam. Yamam means getting away. Ahimsa, Satyam, Asteyam, Brahmacharyam, Aparigraha. The most important here is Aparigraha. Because that is what for us in the Kali Yuga, for us living in this country and everything, that is what is the most important. Okay? Because we don't know what might happen. One day we may be here, tomorrow we don't know what it is. So if you're, we don't even have to connect with the wealth. Let's assume you got used to eating all this jalebi every day. One day after 10 years you go to your blood test. And all the numbers are in 4 digits. Then he says, you can't even write the jalebi in paper. So you got used to that. Then you were somewhere or other. When the wife goes the other way, you try to go and steal somewhere. So she conceals all of them. Still you're trying to, every cupboard you're looking through where it is. So that's what would happen. So that becomes, you start telling the lie. You start stealing that one. You start hurting that one. All these kinds of things. So aparigraha, remember that one. Enough. We don't need more than that. So whether a $10 million is enough or $100 million is enough or $2 billion is enough, none of them. The security has got something, But your disease, what you make it, it would be far higher than that security, or you may not have anything. You'll drop dead like this. Nothing happens, none of the money you used. So you accumulate all of them. Why? Just fear. That is why we are doing all of them. Same thing, everything you take, that is what it is. Next one, niyama. In this one is a do, what you should do. So that is why Krishna was very careful. He says, don't do, you always have to. Do's when it is possible. How carefully he says. And what Krishna gives here is the same thing. Anukulya sangalpam, pradikulya varjanam. We saw in the Prabhati. Same thing also. They cannot teach you any different way. All the sastras teach you. The basic principles are very common and very honest. The question he was asking, how do we know that we are approaching a path? Because Bhagavan cannot be understood by anybody. And if it is that the one, how do I know that I am in the right path? What we follow is the correct one. So it is very hard to say that one, because yado vacho vivattande aprapya manasas saha anandam brahmano vidvana pibedi kudashyaneri. Vedas try to find out who is Bhagavan. It could not find through the words. It cannot find through the manas. All you can understand, anandam brahmano vidvan. Anandam, brahma anandam is amazing. We cannot feel that one. So we try to give the anandam at different levels. Manushya Anandam, and then Gandharva Anandam, and then Deva Anandam, then Devendra Nindran Anandam, then Brahmanuda Anandam. If you go, powers of 10 keep on going. And even if you go, there would be a drop, but you will have a Brahmanandam. However, I explain to you, oh, the jalebi looks so great, it's so juicy, orange color and all this sugar. However, you keep on explaining on the phone, the other person, unless they put it in the tongue, they won't feel it. They will have a sample of knowing what it is. Similarly, what we do with this. But how do you know? But explaining that one, even though you did not have, but you have a good feeling. It looks like I have eaten the jalebi. It feels like that. That is what the Bhagavan is. Even though we haven't seen the Bhagavan, we enjoy the Paripurna Brahmana Bhavam. In Ragasatra Saram, Swami Desigan says, nothing is equivalent. Same thing Tirupanaalvar says, in Kannin Ullana Okkindrade. Ranganada, I was on the other side of the Kaveri and I was thinking and I was beating with this the Veena and I was thinking about you in my heart. And when I came inside, you look exactly the same. He felt like that. So this is what we would do. When we go to the Moksham, then Bhagavan is going to ask you, go see. Aham Brahmasmi. Hey Bhagavan, this is what I learnt in the Shastras. This is what everybody was telling. This is what my Acharya told. And this is what I was waiting for all along. Now I am experiencing. Unless you experience, there is no way to tell. And that experience we cannot get over here. In the Bhakti Yogam, people get some of them. In the Prabhati Yogam, you won't get. Bhakti Yogam is like taking the scenic route. All the roads, all the side attractions would be very nice. But it will take a long time to go to the destination. And what we take is an expressway. Both the sides are like a desert. But we go to the destination very fast. So here, when it's a niyamam, when you say that what you should do, first one is saucham, that is cleanliness. Cleanliness is very important. In everywhere you look at that one, even for Acharya, they says, Andali, one of the Tirupavai Pashuram, she says, white, vellai. Why white is needed? Acharya need three things white, not the vastram. Acharya need three things white. Vastram can be, the Acharya could be any different. So Vastram is not mandatory. Some Acharyas are sannyasis, some of them are white Vastram, Gragasthas. What three things they need? They need teeth. Teeth has to be white. That means you cannot put pawn or you cannot eat anything, whatever you want. That means teeth has to be white, means you have to eat less. That is the first thing. Second one, the Yajyobavidam. That means you have to take a clean shower. Every part you should do all of them, including the Yajyobavidam, that has to be white. Not only that, when you do the rituals, you'll be keep on changing the Yajyobavidam. That is why you should be doing again and again and again many rituals. ஸோ வட் டைம் யூ சே வென் யூ சேஞ்ச் யூர் பூனல் ஓ லாஸ்ட் ஆவணி வாட்டம் லாஸ்ட் யஜுருபாகர்மா வென் இட் வாஸ் தென் மேபி 3-4 இயர்ஸ் பேக் நோ 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 யஜுருபாகர்மா கம்ஸ் எவ்ரி இயர் ஸோ பீப்புள் சே லைக் தட் ஒன் தட் இஸ் த ஒன் செகண்ட் ஒன் தேர்ட் ஒன் த நெயில்ஸ் நெயில்ஸ் ஹஸ் டு பி க்ளீன் இஃப் தி நெயில்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் க்ளீன் வென் தே கிவ் தி அக்ஷதா நோபடி வில் கோ க்ளோஸ் அண்ட் நெயில்ஸ் இஸ் பி க்ளீன் மீன்ஸ் அகெயின் இஸ் நாட் ஈட்டிங் That is why it is clean and everything. And he is doing rituals, always with washing with water. That is why it is clean. So again, if you look at all of them, Saucham, we learn from the Acharya, because Krishna told, go to the Acharya, he will show you. Now we look at the Acharya, oh, Acharya is like that, maybe I should follow that one too. So we start first one. Santosham, second one. The Santosham means here, contentment. Whatever you get, be happy with that. Don't say that, I went there. So they put 2 vadas for him, only 1 vada for me on my plate. Don't start saying all of them. Be contented with what you get. Maybe that's what you deserve. So whatever it is, don't be content. Third one is tapas. Tapas is an amazing word. What most of the people do is tapas means penance. Doing some kind of a prayer, chanting, recitation of mantras. All those kinds of things they say. What is tapas? Tapas is reducing your requirement. Shankara, he gives this definition in one of his things, he gives that one tapas equivalent to basically reducing your requirement. See, if you do Ekadesi Vridam, that is a tapas. If you do the pranayamam, that is the tapas. And if you keep on going one level higher and higher and higher, then if you start floating, that is will be the tapas also. So tapas means reducing your requirement. Next one is swadhyayam. Swadhyayam means all the kinds of thing, parayanam, looking at the books, all the rituals, learning them, all those things put together is called swadhyayam, learning, okay. First, last one is Ishwara Pranidhanam. Means you do the going closer to the Bhagavan, doing Aradhanam, temple going, Sandhya Vandanam, and scriptures. All these things is basically the last one. The first two, Saucham and Santosham, it's almost mandatory for you. Some level you have to be. The last three, what you do, Tapas, Swadhyayam, going to the Ishwara, that is a very difficult to determine. Tapas means out. Vasishtha Bhagavan does tapas differently than what we do tapas. So there's no comparison on that. So they're all very subjective thing. But Saucham is very common for everybody. So I think there is, even in one of the state, there are funny laws in all the states in United States, if you look at that one. I think somewhere in Missouri or something, it is illegal if you don't take a shower for 30 days, at least once. You have to take a shower at least once a month. Otherwise, it's illegal in Missouri or something. So even the government puts a rule like that one. So Saucham, when you say cleanliness is minimal, everybody has to follow. Take shower, wash your hands, keep everything clean. That is very important. Santosham, contentment is also. But tapas, swadhyayam, and then Ishwara Parinidhanam, all those things are basically variable, okay? So now we got these two, yamam and niyamam, don'ts and do's. So now we go to the next level, asanam. So this is where you sit and do swasti asanam, batmasanam, virasanam, gomugasanam, mayuram, bhadram. So many different things are there. Maybe we don't have to worry too much unless you do the yogas. There are a lot of people do yoga not to go for Bhagavan, for the health and spiritual thing, cleanliness of the mind and the body. That is what they do. That is why they do the asanam. The asanam is also important when you do our prayers also, our sandhyavandanam also, and when we do the yagam and yagyam also. So Mukur Lakshmi Narasimhacharya, he sits and does the yagam. You might have seen that. It's a very huge sariram. And he sits and does the Narasimhaya Yajnam. When he does that one, 6 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours, he won't even move a finger All his feet is sitting there and he'll be doing all of them. Doesn't even move. So that is the one called up. Even though his body is so huge, we need to have the control, asana. And then pranayama. Pranayama is basically breathing exercise. Breathing in, holding, exhaling, how you do all of them. Then pratyaharam, self-reflection. See, the bhavam, who we are, how is this atma, how is this body, how we are related and everything. Start reflecting about yourself. And then dharanai. Dharanai means your mind keeps on wavering. Put it into a place. Concentration. That is called dharana. So holding the manas at one thing. Then dhyana. Uninterrupted meditation. So once you come into the dharana, you come to the dhyana. Then samadhi. Samadhi means that's it, you lost yourself. You go into the dhyana for months. Nobody can wake you up into that. This is called the bhakti yoga we have to do. Even hearing itself is hurting. So that is why we went into the easy path of the prabhati. So this is called Ashtanga Yoga. Eight things are there. Ours is called Shadanga Yoga. Just like the eight, we also have the other one. Anukulya Sankalpam, Pradivulya Vajjanam, Karpanyam, Mahavishwasham, Guptirtuvaranam, along with Atma Nikshepam. That is the Atma Samarpanam, Bharanyasam. We do that one. So these are the two parallel paths and everything. So give a little example on the Bhakti Yoga. We don't want to go too much. We'll continue a little on the next class. And then go and see what are the Sishya Lakshanas. So these are, he is giving for the Acharya Lakshanas. When you say the first one, next one says these are the things you should do. When you do this one, you can go to the Acharya. How do you go to the Acharya? At least two things he was saying, Yamam and Niyamam. There are don'ts and do's are there. Follow that one, then access the Acharya. And Acharya, I have given the, what are the qualifications for him? The Acharya qualification is basically Shantam. And he is always knows about me. And he is just a replica of me. So we go to that Acharya. And then he is going to continue. How you going to learn this process? Let's stop here. Kavidharki Gasimmaya Kalyana Gunasalini Simadeva Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Sivare Namaha Mahadeshivaya Namaha.